Hello, my little hamsters. Thank you for joining me again, once again, for chapter 4. Let's see, we just finished... Okay, first of all, the Taco Bell burritos. I'm really upset about this. I have a very specific order. I always get a chicken burrito. I have it grilled, because it's not grilled. It makes the cheese much gooier, and it keeps it warm longer and things like that, because we all know, you know, they don't always heat their stuff. You know, I'm not going to get on the case or anything. But, and then no guacacado sauce, because it's kind of dank and tastes like feet a little bit. And so I do that, and then I order nacho cheese on the side, and I dip it in there, and it's just like, it's perfection. I strongly suggest everybody tries this at some point. But they changed the rice. It used to be the spicy Mexican rice, and now it's like lemon ball sack rice, if anything. So from here, we move on, and we just go straight to the right, and then another little exchange between Anselm and I.
Why are we stopping here? I see nothing of importance.
I gotta take a leak.
This is where we stop. It's the end of the line for us, Sally. So, you really are my enemy.
No. Don't be throwing titles around.
Some good times together?
Judging me.
To what end?
You know, whatever.
Answer me! I don't know, we're running short on time. But I suppose I could answer one question. If it put such a bug up your ass.
Yeah, chill, brother. Chill. Chill,
lie.
Man.
Cross my heart and
nah, you got me all wrong! Got me all wrong! Okay, so at this point, you can choose any of these options. So this is to get you to play through the game a couple of times and really find out what the story is behind everything that's going on. And so we've given you 5 options, and each has a fantastic little exchange between Sally and I. I don't think I want to go through much. I don't want to expose too much of the story, so I'm just going to go for the fight me kind of thing, which is a little homage to Castlevania Symphony of the Night, which is a little bit of, you know, it rather inspired this game. So here we go. Here's our Dracula line.
Enough talk. Have at you.
What is a man? And then come at me, bro. You know, little fan service. I could never dodge that one, that little sweepy attack of mine. Yeah, so the lantern doesn't work on me. And, whoops, clicked off the screen. Yeah, so I'm immune to the lantern, because I made it. It's mine.
Fireball.
Ooh, and then a fireball. Another paralyzer. All right. So this match can go on for a few minutes. I think a punch is coming. Ah! Yep. This is gonna hurt. A lot of improv came for this fight. We didn't have a script for this. It was all improvised. So you get a lot of fun little quips if you hit me with arrows. But don't spam them on me, because then you miss some of the juicy improv that came through. So now that I've told you, I don't take damage, and damage is really irrelevant in this fight. Don't shoot arrows. Just enjoy the fight, learn the patterns, and dodge a lot. Yeah, so there we go. And the music is really good. Just enjoy everything, you know? This is one of the more cinematic fights. And so the fireballs, the fire screens that shoot up, get closer and closer with each passing thing. And then after so long, it just comes together. So right now, your lantern is glowing, which, you know, you all know what that means. That means it's pentagram time! So you throw up a pentagram. Dupa dupa. Ah. Oscar winning performance. Am I right? I mean, that beats any Forrest Gump performance that any Tom Hanks could do. I mean, seriously, that was... Oh, man. That was a beautiful performance. Like, I don't even know. Man, my life has changed. All right, so I'm going to cut it off here, and we'll join up in just another moment. Thank you for joining. Goodbye.